Hi, I'm Chris Hull, an infectious disease physician with Wake Forest Baptist Health and an advisor for COVID to Wake Forest University. I would briefly like to talk to you about isolation and quarantine. There are a lot of facts to know, and there are some fictions out there that I would like to dispel. First, what is isolation and what is quarantine? They're actually different, and the two terms are often used interchangeably in a misleading way, particularly by the media. Isolation is when a person who is infected with a pathogen or has a disease is put in a living situation so that they don't transmit it to other people. The period of isolation for COVID is 10 days. And this is because we know that 99% of people will stop shedding virus after 10 days from the onset of symptoms or from their positive test if they're asymptomatic. Quarantine is when a person who has been exposed to somebody who has known COVID, in other words, they've been exposed to a symptomatic or asymptomatic infected person, they are put in a living situation where they, if they were to go on to get COVID during their period of COVID quarantine, they wouldn't transmit it to other people because they would be in a situation where they're mostly by themselves. Isolation is again for 10 days. Quarantine is for 14 days. Quarantine is longer because it includes the incubation period for COVID, as well as the period of time that virus might be shed if a person were to go on and develop asymptomatic infection. Wake Forest University follows the Centers for Disease Control, the State of North Carolina, and Forsyth County Health Department's guidelines for how both isolation and quarantine should be done. It's very important that when people are in isolation or quarantine, that they limit their social activities, that they stay in their living situation, and that they not travel, particularly travel by public transportation. If you have questions about a particular activity you think you need to do when in isolation and quarantine, you can contact Student Health with your questions. There are a couple of very important fictions about isolation and quarantine. First is that if I'm with a group of friends and one of those people is known to be COVID positive and I've been in contact with them and I was told to go into quarantine, that we could all just do it together. While it might seem that it would be a good use of your resources, it turns out that you don't necessarily go on to get COVID if you've been in contact with somebody who's had it. So if you then put yourself in a living position with that person who has COVID, then your time together is going to be extended and the odds of you getting infected go up, and they actually go up considerably. If you were to do that, your quarantine time will actually get longer because it'll be 14 days from the last time you had contact with that person. So please do not mix isolation and quarantine together. If you're COVID positive, you should stay alone. If you are in quarantine, you should also stay alone. It's not fun, but it's the right thing to do for the health of our friends and other students, as well as our faculty and staff. During that time frame, you can do whatever activities that you might normally otherwise do. You can learn, you can take your classes virtually, watch a movie, but the important thing is to stay indoors. The other big myth about quarantine is that I can test to get out of quarantine. So let's say I was in contact with Susie and I then think, well, now I've been asked to be in quarantine and I can test to get out of it, which means if the test is negative, I'm done. That's actually not true, because a person could go on to get COVID and become test positive at any time during that 14 days. So if you test on day 2 you could still become positive on day five. If you test on day five, it's possible you can get test positive on day seven, so on and so forth. So even if you test negative during your period of quarantine, you still need to quarantine for the full 14 days. It may not be intuitive, but that's just the way it is. And it's because the virus can pop up during any time during that period. In fact, CDC's, the state's, and Forsyth County's guidance says that even if you have a negative test during the period of quarantine, you still need to stay quarantined for 14 days. I hope this answers some questions and clears some things up about isolation and quarantine. Again, if you have questions, please contact your student body leadership, Wake Forest University, or Wake Forest Student Health.